Good afternoon to Anadol Prasad here. Today I am going to discuss the topic Keynes theory of money and price. And a traditional quantity theory of money does not explain how changes in the supply of money and to bring about changes in the price level. And Keynes also tried to rectify this defect, that it has been introduced the new theory. It is the Keynes theory of money and prices. And the Keynes are also argue that the changes in the quantity of money and changes in the price level. But he does not accept that there is a direct and a proportionate relationship between the quantity of money and the price level. And he also presented the reformulated theory of the quantity theory of money and the price level. And the quantity theory of money, there is a links between the theory of the rate of interest. The next, the economics has been divided into the two compartments. The no doors and no windows, and the relationship between the quantity of money and the price level. But the quantity of money, if it is increases, so there is no direct and proportionate relationship between the price level. And next, so the Keynes theory of money and prices, if it is explained to him, there is a direct relationship between the price level. The economics has been divided into the two compartments, and no doors and no windows, that between the quantity of money and the price level. That is, this division, it is the relative price and absolute prices. The relative prices, there is a determined between the demand and the supply of goods, and the absolute price, it has been determined only on the demand and the supply of money. So the Keynes theory of the money and the prices, if it changes in the quantity of money and changes in the price level, and it has been indirectly affected by the economic activities, as like the rate of interest, investment, quantity of money, and the price level, output, income, and employment. And next, the Keynes theory of money and prices, if it is explained only on the quantity theory of money and the price level. The Keynes theory of money and price can be explained at the economy if it is the less than full employment. If the economy is the less than full employment, and it has been used as the unemployed productive resources. And the money is demanded, it is not only used for the transaction purpose, but it has been used and the money is called liquid asset, and it may be used for the investment and the speculative purpose. So if it is the money supply, it has been increases, that it has been money supply, if it is increases, and it has been increasing the liquid asset, and it has been reducing the rate of interest. If there is the reducing the rate of interest, it induces the investment to increase. That is, reducing the rate of interest and investment are also increases. The investment is increases through only on the multiplier effect. The multiplier effect, that is the multiplier effect, if it is increases, that it has been leads to increasing the employment, output, income, and even the price level are also to be increasing. And next also, if the Keynes theory of the money and the prices, if it is increasing the effective demand, that it has been increasing the money supply. That is, effective demand is increasing, that it has been increasing the money supply also. And the increasing the effective demand, that it has been leads to the price, it is not the proportionate relationship between the increasing the price level. But the effective demand is increasing, if there is the economy, it is the less than full employment, the effective demand are also to be increasing, that it has been leads to increasing the output, income, and employment. So the Keynes theory of money and prices, if it is related only on the employment situation. And next, so the Keynes theory of
only
The King's theory of quantity theory of money and prices advancement leads to the following process. The first one is the changes in the quantity of money, and next one is the changes in the rate of interest, and next is the changes in the investment, and next is the changes in the income, and changes in employment, and changes in output, and finally if it is increasing the price level. That is the process. That is the one is the quantity of money, if it is increasing, that is leads to the rate of interest and investment and income, output and employment. Finally, the price level are also to be increasing. And next is the Keynes, it has been reformulated the theory that it has been known as the old quantity theory, and it has been diagrammatically explained by Keynes. And O-axis, it has been the first diagram, that is the A. It is O-axis, it has been represent the output, and O-axis, it has been represent the quantity of money. That is the quantity of money, if it is increasing and the output are also to be increasing, that portion it is known as OTC. That is the output are also increasing. The next is the quantity of money, if it is reached at full employment level, if it is known as the OM, and output are also to be increased up to the OQF. That is OQF level, the output are also to be increased. After the full employment level, the output are also to be vertical, and further the quantity of money it is increasing, the price level are also increases, but it's not the output are also increasing. That is the reformulated the quantity theory of money. And next is the next diagram, it's the P diagram. On the other hand, the price level are also to be increasing, the quantity of money are also to be increasing, that after the full employment level, that portion is RC, that it has been known as the PRC. And next is the Keynes quantity theory of money, it can be explained diagrammatically that it has been represent only on the aggregate demand and aggregate supply. And O x-axis it has been represented by output, and O y-axis it has been represented by the price level. If there is the aggregate demand is increasing, the D1 and D2, and same level the output are also to be increases, the Q1 and Q2, with the same level of prices at OP. Suppose the aggregate demand is further increasing, that is D2 and D3, the output are also to be increasing, the Q2 and Q3, and the price are also to be changes from the OP to OP3. Finally, the output it has been reached at the OQF, and the output cannot be raised. That is output, it is known as the vertical axis. And after the full employment level, it has been reached to our economy, the output cannot be increased, and the quantity of money and price level are also increasing. That it has been explained by Keynes. And next is the assumption of the Keynes theory of the money and prices. Assumption of the Keynes theory of money and prices. That is the first assumption is all the factors of production, if it is perfectly elastic, that it has been known as the first assumption of the Keynes theory of money and prices. And second one, all the unemployed factors are homogeneous. There are the two factors in the economy, one is the homogeneous, another one is exogenous, sorry, homogeneous and heterogeneous, and all the unemployment factors, the Keynes are also to be explained only on the homogeneous, it is not only that heterogeneous. And next, there is a constant return to scale, that is why it is a constant return to scale, the Keynes are also to be explained. If the price are increasing or the decreasing, but the output level are also to be increasing. So it has been explained only on the constant return to scale. And next, the criticism of the Keynes theory of the money and prices. That is, there are the some of the criticism of the Keynes theory of the money and the prices. The first one, this theory, it has been explained only on the perfectly elastic supply of money, perfectly elastic supply of money due to the productive resources. This assumption is the unrealistic one, because in most of the UDSs or the underdeveloped countries, the productive resources are also to be known as the shortened supply, because this theory, it is the one of the defects of this theory. And next is, and further, this theory are also to be assumed that the perfectly inelastic supply of the productive resources after the full employment level. So this assumption, it is the fair in realities to that country. And next, if it is increasing the effective it is based only on the false assumption that is increasing the effective demand, that it has been leads to increasing the supply of money. It is only after the full employment level, it is not only the before full employment level. And next, and this theory, it is fully based only on the quantity theory of money and price level, but there is no links between the rate of interest. And next, if there is explained only on the quantity theory of money, if it is definitely links to the rate of interest, but the Keynes is the entire theory, it is based only on the quantity theory of money and the price level, it is not to be linked between the rate of interest. And finally, the Keynes theory, it is the two general theory, but it fails to explain the sectional price behavior to that country. And this are also to be known as some of the defects of the Keynes theory of the money and prices. And we are also conclude that the Keynes theory of the money and prices, it's definitely superior to the whole quantity theory, because since it is recognized the problems of the unemployed resources to that economy. Thank you. Thank you, girls.